Today, we'll learn how to migrate your data from QuickBooks POS to Shopify. The migration process comprises three steps. Let's walk through the first step, which is completing the prerequisites. Once you open your Shopify store, you'll be able to find the QuickBooks Desktop Connector app within your app section. Once open, click Get Started. Under this, you will see Prerequisites for Migration. Each of these links will take you to a detailed explanation on how to complete the step. If you have any questions on this, please feel free to reach out to your support agent. Once you complete the prerequisites, open your QuickBooks POS and check the version number. Make sure you are on the latest version and latest release of QuickBooks POS. Congratulations! You have completed the first prerequisite step. Now let's move on to the second step, exporting data from QuickBooks POS. Open your QuickBooks POS. Go to File for Utilities. Export. We will be exporting inventory items, customers, and vendors. Let's start with inventory items. Select the location you would like to export your data to. Select Worksheet as Sheet 1 for Export, Template, select Add New. Make sure you click Select All. Give this a template name and click Save. Now, click Next and export your files. Make sure you have Microsoft Excel installed on your system for the export to work smoothly. Once the inventory export is completed, we'll be repeating the same steps for customers as well as vendor data. To keep the tutorial short, I've already exported all the three data files required. That marks the completion of the second step. Now, let's move on to the third step of importing data onto the Connector app. Open your Shopify store and the Connector app. In here, you'll find three data fields: inventory, customers, and vendors. Let's upload the respective data files here. Once the upload is completed, click here to find your stocky API key. Click on Generate a New API Key and copy this key. Next, paste the key in this field. With that, we come to the product barcode mapping screen. Here, you need to select which of these fields to use to map your product barcodes. Is it the item number or the UPC? In this example, we'll go with item numbers. The second question is location matching. You would need to match each of these locations to an appropriate Shopify location. If you have more than one location or you'd like to add new, click here and you will be able to add a new location. Once you add a new location, hit the refresh button and the location will show up in the dropdown. Make sure you select appropriate locations and match them accordingly. With this, we can now start the migration. The migration might take a few minutes to a couple of hours to progress, depending on the amount of data. Once the migration is completed, you will be notified by email. Thank you, and please don't hesitate to contact us if you have any questions.